The Lord reigns. Let the earth be glad. Let the distant shores rejoice. Clouds and thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his throne. Fire goes before him and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. The earth sees and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all peoples will see his glory. Oh, we want to see your glory, God. Oh, God, we want to see your glory. You want to see his glory? Lift your voices. Lift your hands. We want to see your glory, God. Oh, send down your power. Oh, God, send your glory. We want to see you move in our generations, oh, God.
Good morning to everyone. So good to see that people have found their ways out of their igloos and their other ice-bound locations to come back and join together in fellowship. So good to see everyone today. And we're going to enter into worship, singing glory to his name. Start us up and restore some of the momentum. I think that's what we've been talking about this week. It feels like we just lost momentum. Cold and the ice has slowed us down. We're just going to kind of get our momentum going again. Remember that God is at work in this world, and we're a part of that family.
my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship this holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I'll worship your holy name. Bless the Lord, oh, my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy name. Worthy.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah to your name, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah to your name. As we prepare to pray, this word that just came, just the passage that I had chosen to read today, John 17, is the Jesus' prayer that's basically been repeated right here. Jesus said in 17:13, I'm coming to you now, but I say these things while I'm still in the world, so that they, my followers, may have a full measure of joy within them. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them, for they are not of the world any more than I am of the world. My prayer, and this is just echoes exactly what we heard, my prayer is not that you would take them out of the world, but that you would protect them from the evil one. They are not of this world, even as I am not of this world. So sanctify them by your truth. Your word is truth. This world is not our home. It's our tent dwelling. It's the place we're passing through on our way to an eternal home. But while we're here, he has something for us to do. While we're here, he has a task for us, and that is to bring glory to his name. And here's the deal. Sometimes we think it's all, sometimes, I know I have a tendency to do this when I'm preaching. I either do an either or. I either focus on, we've got to work, we got to work, we got to work, or I focus on, God will meet your needs, God will meet your needs, God will meet your needs. It's not either or. God will meet your needs so that you're able to live a life to his glory. God will meet your needs so that you're able to work for him. God doesn't want broken people trying to work for him. He wants to make us whole. He wants to make us whole. Now, we don't forget that we were broken, but he wants to make us whole so that we can serve him. So if you have needs today, needs in your body, needs in your family, needs in your finances, call out today to the Lord in faith. He wants to meet those needs. He's not going to take us out of this world. We're going to be here until he does take us out of this world. We've got that hope as well. But he's not taking us out of this world right at this moment. So and then until that time, he's going to meet the needs that we have so we can live to the praise of his glory. Let's go to the Lord in prayer right now. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you that you hear our prayers. Thank you that we're not just praying into the air. Thank you, Lord, that you do care for our needs. You do care for the things that are going on in our lives, Lord. You hear them. You see them. You know them. We can trust in you, Lord Jesus. And you want to use us, Lord. You want to use us for your glory. But you know you've got to make us able to be able to function, able to be able to live our lives in order to do this. So I pray right now for those who are still dealing with the ramifications of this horrible cold snap. God, I pray those who have financial needs, who have needs in their home, God, bring about solutions, bring about resolution very quickly, we pray. For those who are going through physical difficulties, Lord, bring healing. For those who are going through emotional, the trauma of having faced many trials, Lord Jesus, bring restoration, bring wholeness, Lord. You are a God of wholeness. We thank you, Lord Jesus. You care about our whole life, and you want us to live our whole life to the praise of your glory, Jesus. Let it be in our lives today, Lord. Let this group of believers who fellowship together here, let us live to the praise of your glory in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. Well, let's take a few minutes, if you feel comfortable doing so, giving greetings to one another. It might have been a week since you see somebody's smiling face, so get out and say hello. Be sure and hand in your offerings. The bucket's there for tithe and offering. We really appreciate your faithfulness in giving.
Some words on a page, but you're nothing more than fables handed down along the way. But I've seen you parking waters where no one else could pull me from. Deep, that's who you are to me.
Some people think you just live in cathedrals made of stone, but I know you live inside my heart. I know that it's your home. And I've seen you in a sunset in the eyes of a stranger on the street. That's who you are to me.
You're amazing, faithful, love's open door. When I'm empty, you fill me with hunger for more of your mercy, your goodness. Lord, you're the air that I breathe. That's who you are to me. Who you are to me.
Sometimes I have my doubts, I'm sure that everybody does. And I wonder when I stumble, am I still worthy of your love?
But I know that I get stronger when I'm talking to you down on my knees.
You're everything I need. You're amazing, faithful, love's open door. When I'm empty, you fill me with hunger for more of your mercy, your goodness. Lord, you're
seasons change, you stay the same. ran from you and wandered in the shadows and found a God who relentlessly pursues. I hid from you, haunted by my failure, and found a God whose grace still covers me. I fell on you. I was at my weakest and found the God.
The snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal. The snowman was a jolly happy soul.
We've got our history lesson right now. Come on. All right, we're going to take today and we're going to learn about the great storm that happened in 2021 in Waxahachie, Texas. One day, the children made a snowman and they called him Frosty. And it was so cold, but they didn't care because they were having such a good time. And when they put the hat on...
It's cold in Texas here.
Frosty, it hasn't been this cold in over 100 years. We had to cancel prayers, Friends Day, and Sunday service. Yeah, it was terrible, terrible, awful, terrible. Yeah.
Hey, guys, not this week, though. This week, on Wednesday, we're going to have Clancy Hayes, 7 p.m., prayer meeting at 6, and Sunday service. Everything's going to be just like it was before, except the men's and women's meeting's canceled.
Yeah, Jeff and Jennifer Bell are going to take a dreamy vacation on March 6th. Uh-oh.
What's the matter, Frosty?
Crazy Texas weather. One day it's -5, and then next week it's 67. I can't live here in Texas.
Yep, in a couple of days. All that Frosty was a puddle on the ground. Poor little girl. But that's just the way it is in Texas. One day cold, next day hot. Nothing you can do about it.
And that's a sad, sad story of Frosty the Snowman when he came to Texas. That's the truth, and there's nothing else to be said.
The snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal.
Taken from an Eastern musical that we did many years ago, and the song, it's actually the Apostle Peter and then Mary Magdalene singing, and they're singing the song that they would be singing when they saw Jesus going up and carrying the cross. And the question of the song is that my cross he's taking to Calvary? Die for him, I really thought I could. There I was denying him. I never thought I would. I failed the Lord, I let him down. After all he's done for me, now he's walking up a hill, a hill called Calvary. Calvary, Calvary. Was it meant for him? Was it meant for me? Calvary, Calvary. Is that my cross he's taken to Calvary?
I've done everything. There we go. It wasn't my fault. Well, how many of you thawed out? It's actually warm up here on this platform. If you'd like to come up and join me. Thank you for getting out today. We've been shut up for, seems like forever. The COVID mess and then the Snowmageddon. We're just not used to this, are we? No, that's why we live in Texas. We don't want to put up with this stuff. Well, I'm glad you're here today. I want to encourage you. I feel like the Lord's about to come again. And I think we can't put a date on when he's coming. But we know when some events are about to occur, because the Bible tells us that he does nothing without he lets his prophets know first. And listen, there's so many prophets today. I think we ought to gather up a pile of rocks and thin the crowd out a little bit, because I'm not sure some of them are hearing from God. And the ones that are hearing from God, I'm not sure they're getting the right publicity. But there are things occurring in the world today that I think we have to be real cognizant of. NASA discovered an asteroid that's headed to Earth. One of the reasons that the president created the Space Army or whatever he called Space Force was because of this asteroid that's headed to Earth. You can look this up in NASA, and you can find that what I'm about to say is all fact. They've given it a name. It's an Egyptian dinosaur, an Egyptian god, Zophar. And it's targeted to hit the Earth in 2129. They actually know about when. Now NASA has come out and said, well, it's not going to hit the Earth. It's going to pass really, really, really close. And our moon is about 228,000, 225,000 miles away from the Earth. And they say now this thing's going to pass about 65,000 miles from the Earth. Well, that's pretty close. But they're still making plans because they feel like that the possibility of it hitting the Earth is pretty powerful. And they think if it hits the Earth, it's going to hit partially on land, partially in the sea. They're not sure where. It's a weird shaped, now this has something to do with my sermon, so stay with me. I had to wake you up to get going here. This asteroid is shaped kind of weird. It's sort of bigger on the ends than it is in the middle, and it fluctuates. Its flight is kind of erratic. And so they estimate that if it hits land, it's going to kill at least 2 billion people and destroy Revelation chapter, what is it, 11? A third of the earth. And it'll be one of the greatest catastrophes known in modern times. Now, if you read Revelation, it tells us that there's going to be a star called Wormwood that's going to fall on the earth. And if we believe what we've been taught, that that's going to happen about mid-tribulation, and if this thing, and by the way, Zophar, they've called Wormwood. It's one and the same, they say. If it hits in 2019, they actually know the date. So if you back up about three and a half years, what are you doing?
Said 2019.
2119. Yeah. Hey, I haven't caught up yet. I've been in my easy chair for 3 or 4 weeks. So if you back up, you know, maybe the Lord's coming is a lot sooner than we think. If we believe in a pre-tribulation rapture, which is what the Assemblies of God teaches, then maybe the rapture of the church is going to happen before this thing takes place. We don't know. I think we need to be ready either way. So, if this is 2021, and you back up three and a half years to say 2125, that'll be here before we know it. And most of us in this room, probably all of us in this room, are going to be here. Wow, isn't that exciting? I came to church today, got out, braved the weather, find out we're going to get hit by an asteroid and we're all going to die. I'm telling you this, not that I'm speaking prophetically necessarily. These can be proven, a lot of this can be proven scientifically of what's happening. And so I think it behooves us to be ready. So if this is 2021, see, I caught up. and we're talking about 2025. How many of you know 2025 will be here before we know it? I mean, it seems to me like Christmas is just going to be here in a couple of weeks. And before you would know it, it'll be Christmas again. And time is seemingly escalating, or it's picking up its pace. I think it's because we stay so busy. We feel like time is just flying. I think the older I get, time gets faster. How many of you know what I'm talking about? I never thought we would make it to 21, whatever this is. 2021. I never thought. I thought the Lord come for now. So what I sense in my spirit, an urgency for the church to step up and be the church. And to be more powerful than it's ever been before. Most of our world today is accustomed to false advertising. We're told that certain things will do certain things. And then the next half of the commercial is telling you all of the after effects or the possibilities of what's going to happen. When we see something in advertising, I'm telling you, nothing looks better than a Whataburger on commercial. I mean, I'd almost eat a McDonald's burger on commercial. We realize it's made to look better than it really is. And sadly, much of the church today is the same way. We hear that God is our healer and our deliverer and our counselor and etc. But we do not see the product of our advertisement. You're quiet. When we receive baptism of the Holy Spirit, it's more than just a license to speak in another tongue. It is to empower us to be witnesses. We should be walking in an authority that is God-given. We are spirit-filled people. And that makes us different. I don't know about you, but I think we have something the Baptists don't have. And if you're Baptist and watching me, watch and learn. Jesus came to give us a new covenant. In the old covenant, Adam was given great power and authority. He named all the animals. He was instructed to have dominion over all living creatures. He was given stewardship of the entire world in Genesis 1:26. He was made in the image of God himself. And it says, and God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it, and have dominion. If that much authority was given under an old covenant, how much more authority has been given under a new covenant? I'm going to say that again. If that much authority was given under an old covenant, how much more authority has been given to us under a new and a better covenant? The whole theme of the book of Hebrews is, it's better. Christ is better. And this new covenant is better. In Matthew 28, verse 18, Jesus said, all power, everybody say all power. All power. In heaven and earth has been given to me. Now go and teach all nations. In Mark 16, 17 through 18, Jesus said, these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. Somebody say amen. Amen. He said in Matthew 16 and 19, and I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven, and whatever, somebody say whatever. Whatever. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Are you staying with me right now? Again in chapter 18, verse 18 through 19. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. And if, everybody say if. And if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done of them of my Father which is in heaven. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Matthew 6, 7 and 8. Ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened to you. For everyone that asks receives, and he that seeks finds, and he that knocks, it will be open. There's no shadow of doubt in any of these scriptures. In Luke 10, verses 1 through 20, he commissioned the 70 to go out and heal the sick and tell them that the kingdom of heaven has come near them. They returned with joy, and Jesus said to them, behold, I give you power over all the power of the enemy, and nothing, everybody say nothing,
nothing
shall by any means hurt you. So glad to have Norma Gonzalez with us this morning. Norma's from Argentina. She is a true evangelist. Steve Hill won her to the Lord. She was an atheist communist. And he won her to the Lord at a phone kiosk in the mall.
Wow.
She's been all over the world serving Jesus and working. And we're honored to have you here today, Norma. Now, the Syrophoenician woman, you remember, came to Jesus. She was asking for the healing of her daughter. And Jesus said, hey, the children's bread don't belong to the dogs or the Gentiles. And she replied, even the dogs eat crumbs from the master's table. And Jesus healed her daughter. This indicates that healing is the children's bread. And if you and I are children of the Most High God, we have a right to expect healing as a normal part of our lives. Somebody say hallelujah. Now, when we were saved and baptized in Holy Spirit, a new power invaded us. We became sons and daughters of God, and the new covenant began to take effect in our lives. If Adam had God-given authority, so do we. Acts 1 and 8, but you shall receive, come on, but you shall receive after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And you shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the uttermost parts of the world. Somebody shout, praise the Lord. We have a right and authority to command evil spirits to loosen us from infirmities, from disease, from infertility, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I can't tell you how many times we prayed for young couples that were trying to have children and were told it was impossible. The Bible says it's our right and we must go and multiply. And so we tell the body, you have to multiply because God created you to multiply. And it's not long till there's a baby. Wow. The authority God's given us. I told this story 3 years ago, but a lot of you weren't here then. And that's the privilege of pastors. When you reach my age, you can tell stories over and over all you want. We were in Haiti back in the early 1980s, and the missionary said, I want to tell you one of the greatest stories of healing that I've ever heard. And she began to tell us the story of a young pastor and his wife who pastored out in the bush. They were trying to pastor a little church, and they hadn't been able to win one person in their community. It was an almost impossible situation, but they were trying to have a child. And one day they come riding in on their bicycle and they said, God told us to come, and if you would pray for us, we would have a child. So the missionary said, you know, I prayed. Well, 10 months later, they come rolling in with a one-month-old baby, little baby boy. They dedicate him to the Lord. They get back home and start working again. It's a fruitless job. There seemed like there's nothing happening. And the baby became ill. In those early years, nearly about 80% of the babies born there died. And mostly the reason was when they severed the umbilical cord, they usually didn't use sterile equipment. And so, anyway, the tetanus, you know, whatever you get tetanus for, what's the stuff? Anyway, it would set in and the babies would die. This happened to this little boy. He swelled up and the whole community is watching this and he dies. And the pastor says to his wife and mother, don't do anything with a baby. I'm going out to the bush and I'm going to pray. 3 days later, he comes back. By now, in that tropical heat of Haiti, the baby's body has bloated. And I'm going to tell you the story the way it was told to me. There were now maggots crawling out of the orifices of the body. It was already in the process of decay. But the pastor took that little boy in his hands and he walked out into the middle of the village, which was a little stream. And he stood in the middle of that stream and he held that baby up to heaven and he began to pray. And in the middle of his prayer, the baby came back to life and started kicking. I'm talking about power and authority. If Jesus can raise Lazarus having been dead for 4 days, come on. Sometime we believe our false advertising and we don't realize what God has really granted for us. Our encounter with God gave us power. Everybody say power. I don't know about you, but I like that word. I like that word, power. Our infilling of Holy Ghost gives us power. Moses had an encounter that empowered him in the eyes of Pharaoh and the people of Israel. Elijah had an encounter that caused him to even call fire down out of heaven. But under Holy Ghost, Peter has an encounter that caused him to dare to call out a man begging for alms and say, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he leaped to his feet. Our encounter with God should empower us. Amen. I quote it again, but you shall receive power. Say it with me, but you shall receive. Can we make it personal and say, I shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon me. And I shall be witness in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and to the uttermost parts of the world. The scripture I quote to you often, Ephesians 3:20. Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly and abundantly and above all, we could even ask or think according to the power that works inside of us. I ask you this morning, what is the power that works inside of you? Is it faith? Jesus said, if you have faith as a grain of a mustard seed, you can say to this mountain, be cast into the sea, and it has to obey. He didn't say you had to have great faith. He said faith as a mustard seed. What power works inside of you? Is it authority and dominion? I've prayed for thousands of people in my years of ministry. When someone comes up and I say, what do you need from the Lord? And they go like this, well, I've been fighting this thing for years. I've had a lot of people pray for me, but Pastor, nothing ever seems to happen, so would you pray? What is the use? When somebody comes up, I never forget standing beside a person who was dying. And the wife looks at me and she says, I know he's dying, but if you will pray for him, he'll be all right. That's faith. That's faith. All you got to do then is pray. Do we pray with power and authority and dominion? Do we pray as people who know God is listening to us? We're not wondering, is the Father listening to me? We're not wondering what's going to happen. We know who we're talking to. We know what God is capable of doing. And we know what His Word says. I've read to you over and over and over, scripture after scripture this morning. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. And I want to awaken this church, because we may only have a few years before the Lord comes again. And I want us to be a church of power. I want us to be a church of authority. I want us to be a church that sees the miraculous. I want us to be a church that changes lives. I want us to be a church that walks in the power and the authority of Holy Spirit. Come on, lift your hands and worship the Lord a moment, would you? What power works inside of you? Faith, authority, dominion, confidence? Or is it fear and unbelief? What if I pray and nothing happens? Is it doubt and indecision? James said, if you're undecided when you pray, don't expect an answer. Now, I paraphrase that. He said it's useless to pray. God has not given us a spirit of fear. And it's time for the church to rise up and be the church. We can no longer make excuses for our false advertising. We can no longer tolerate what God has given us power to change. I pray, and I've had this sermon now for 2 weeks. If we could have had church last Sunday, you'd have heard it then. I pray that this becomes a turnaround Sunday. That we no longer tolerate what we don't have to tolerate. This morning, I want you to listen these last minute or so. Listen closely. I release into you this morning authority. Comes from heaven. Comes from Holy Ghost. Comes from the blood of Jesus. I'll never forget being very ill one night, awakening at about 2 o'clock in the morning, and I knew something was terribly wrong, and I heard a voice, an audible voice, says, I'm going to kill you tonight. You're going to die of a heart attack. I knew the possibilities were there. And great fear came over me, Norma, huge. And I, all of a sudden, something clicked inside of me. And I looked, sat up in bed and said, you lying spirit. You couldn't kill me if you had to. Jesus holds the keys of death and of hell. And I rebuke you in the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus. And instantly that spirit went away. And instantly my body was touched by the power of God. I release authority. I release dominion. I release faith and boldness and power. And if you don't have that power this morning, you need a new infilling of Holy Spirit. If you've never been filled with Holy Spirit, today's the day to be filled with Holy Spirit. We're not going to be a church that says something on the front door and has nothing inside the building. We're not going to be a church that talks about our 16 fundamental faith and we don't have the authority that goes along with it. We're not going to be a church that says God can and we never see it happen. We're not going to be that kind of a church. Lift your hand to heaven and say, I'm going to follow God no matter what. I ask you this morning, do you have that power? Is it residing inside of you? Power over our body. Power over things. Power over circumstances. Power over situations. Power and authority. Power and authority. Power and authority. Either this book is right or it's all a lie. I refuse to believe that part of it's untrue. I believe it from cover to cover. And if Joshua can look up in the heavens and command the sun to stand still, then that same power is available to us. If Moses can throw down its staff and it become a serpent, then that same power is ours, because we serve the same God, Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Somebody shout, I thank you, Jesus. Come on, shout it. God wants to use you in the interpretation. Give it quickly. The Lord wants to confirm His word this morning.
Did I not tell you that greater things you would still do?
Yeah.
While I was still on this earth, I said you would do greater things than this.
Yeah.
That means now and forever. It did not mean just then. I did not command these things to just glorify the church. They were to glorify me.
Yeah.
They will not be able to glorify you. You will not be able to take a single grain for yourself. It will all go to me.
Yeah.
Expect the unexpected.
Yeah.
Expect me to move where you don't think I can move. Believe, yeah. And it's going to happen.
Yeah.
Greater things you can still do.
Oh, hallelujah. Come on. Stand to your feet and lift your hands. Stand, lift your hands to heaven. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. 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 The word repent means change the way you think. We have to change the way we think. So the old saying is, as you think, so you are. A lot of us have adjusted to false advertising. God wants to set his church on fire again. If this morning, you want a new infilling of Holy Spirit, you want a new empowerment, come stand with me at the front. You want to be the church of power, church of glory, the church of dominion, the church of authority, the church who sees things happen. Come stand with me at the front. Come on, move in. Move in. We don't have quite as much room as we normally have. Lift your hands and worship God, would you? The Lord, pour out a fresh spirit upon us. We want to heed your word this morning. You're getting your church ready. I pray right now that Holy Spirit begin to fall. A new encounter. A new spirit. A spirit of power and dominion begin to take us. Let faith begin to arise. Let confidence begin to arise. Let grace begin to impact our life. Lord, pour out your spirit new. Come on, ask God to give you a new infilling. Come on, let God do something new in you this morning. We want fresh fire. We want fresh fire on the altar. May an angel of heaven come and touch us. Fresh fire, oh God. Fresh fire. Fresh anointing, fresh authority. Hallelujah. 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 We will not be denied. We shall be everything God said we are. We shall do what God said we could do. Come on, let Holy Ghost fill you again. Come on, start praying in the Spirit. Come on, pray in the Spirit this morning. Pray in the Spirit. Suranda rabasata le diya torala bahata. Kola basita la bokosa talaba. Come in the name of Jesus. Come, you are the baptizer. Baptize us anew and afresh, O God. In the name of Jesus. Set your church on fire. Set your church on fire again, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Set your church on fire. Oh God, we've been hungering for this. We've been longing for this. Set your church on fire, oh God. Spirit in us that will not be denied. In Jesus' name. 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 In Jesus' name.
For I tell you, you are not too old, you are not too young. There is nothing that I cannot do through you. Just do what I've called you to do. Yeah. Ignore the age boundary on what I have called you to do. What you have placed as an age boundary, I did not. You are not too old to pass wisdom to the young. The young are not too old to pass wisdom to you. Look towards each other. Work together. Do not think you are too old. Do not think you are too young. Yes. I have called you all to help the cause. Yes. I have called you all to help those in need. Yes. That yes. is what I have called you to
yes.
do.
Yes.
It does not matter your age, your color, nothing matters.
Yes,
all that matters is that I have called you.
Yes.
That is it. Yes. Do not worry about age. Do not worry about time.
Yes.
I have it in my hand.
Yes, you
do what I have called you to do.
Come on, let's receive the word. Wow. There's a powerful anointing in here this morning. Holy Spirit is strong. Hallelujah. If you need healing in your body, place your hand wherever you need healing and command your body to receive the word of the Lord. By his stripes, you are healed. Come on, right where you're standing. Right where you're standing. Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I command the body to hear the word of the Lord. By his stripes, we are healed. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. By his blood. By his blood. By his blood. By his blood. Now, Lord, we cast out fear. We cast out fear in the name of Jesus. You didn't give us fear. We cast it out in Jesus' name. We cast out timidity. We release boldness. I release boldness. I release boldness. Power. 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 In the name of Jesus. 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 Thank you. Come on. Come on, press through. Press through the flesh. Press through the flesh. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Press through the flesh. The woman with the issue of blood pressed through the flesh until she touched the hem of his garment. Press through the flesh this morning. Hallelujah. Lord, we believe you've called us as the last generation. We're the ones that's going to see the return of you. We're the ones going to see your church in power and glory, dominion. Give us boldness. Give us energy. Give us revelation. Give us strength. Empower us as we cast off fear. We cast off restrictions. We cast off false advertising in the name of Jesus. Of the Lord is in this place. I can feel his mighty power. His grace. I can hear of angels wings. I see glory on his face. Thank you, thank you. I receive it. I receive it gladly. We've come under attack. Some of it's the devil. A lot of it's our flesh. We do things wrong. We do things stupid. We reap because of it. So I don't blame the devil for everything that's happening to me, but it feels like I'm falling apart. Thank you for that word. God's not finished with any of us here. We're all here for a reason and a purpose. Step into your purpose. Unafraidly. Unfearfully, whatever the word is. Don't be afraid. Be all that God's called you and told you you could be. Some of you are going to begin to see the fulfillment of prophecies that have been spoken over you for decades. You're going to see, oh, wow. That's what God meant. This is what God's doing. You're going to see the fulfillment of that. Walk in a new authority. Walk in a new dominion. Walk in a new power. Walk in grace. This is our time. Look at somebody and say, this is my time. Well, I still feel Holy Ghost in the room. God's spoken to us so powerfully this morning. The scripture tells us we're to receive the word gladly. And I receive it. Now, don't walk out of here and be like you've been every Sunday before now. God's going to put a hunger in you. Something's going to begin to pull. You're going to find that you want to read the Word more. You're going to hear a voice behind you saying, this is what you do. This is how you walk. This is how you walk. God's going to begin to bless you. I'd love it. Turn you loose on the world. Raise your right hand. May the power of God and the residue of His presence be over you this entire week. May you be like Moses when he came off the mountain and the glory of God shone upon him. May your ear be attentive to the voice of the Spirit, that you be obedient to what He wants to accomplish. And may boldness and strength be in your life. I bless you spiritually, physically, financially, relationally. In the name of Jesus, be blessed. I love you. We're so happy to be here. God bless you.